Three, two, one, go.
Happy Friday, NCHS! Good morning, everyone. I'm Tanisha Carfiello, coming to you live from the NCTV studio. Today is Friday, March 4th, and a day A.
And I'm Leah Massioni. It's been a crazy couple of days with juniors taking the SAT on Wednesday, but you know what they say, news never sleeps, and we're here to give it to you. Before we get to all that, let's rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
On March 15th, all 10th graders will be taking the Connecticut Academic Performance Test, also known as the CAP test in science. The test will take place in the morning from 7:30 to 9:50. Period 4 will mark the first class of the day and will start promptly at 9:55. Sorry, sophomores, but everyone else gets to sleep in.
Actually, Tanisha, not everyone will be sleeping in that morning. Seniors who are doing an internship need to come to a mandatory training workshop during the CAP testing time. Report to the cafeteria by 7:30.
I'm not sure how many of you know NC resident Warner DePew. Mr. DePew is the co-founder of the Wilburn Fellowship. This weekend, Mr. DePew's son, Nick DePew, is holding a benefit concert to raise money for his mother, who has ALS. The concert takes place at the First Presbyterian Church, starting at 7:30. It's open to the public, so make sure to come out and support a heartwarming cause. If you can't be there, NCTV will be filming the event and selling DVDs to help raise money for this cause. So make sure to look for it on Channel 78 in the upcoming weeks.
With the start of March this week, Safe Driving Month is here. The NCHS Parent Faculty Association, along with several community and town agencies, are hosting a safe driving program at NCHS for the next 2 weeks. On Wednesday, March 9th, don't go to your period four class because there will be a safe driving assembly to kick off the month.
Last Friday, NCHS hosted the Senior Prom Fashion Show in the auditorium. About 115 seniors strutted their stuff in outfits from Vineyard Vines, A Step Ahead, Camilo's, Joseph A. Banks, Karen Forbes, and other stores around town. Not only did students model, but also many faculty, including Principal Egan and Mr. Rothman. The show also featured a performance from the cast from Into the Woods. The audience got to participate in many raffles that gave out many different prizes. Overall, the fashion show was a huge success, and thank you to everyone who came out to support the senior post-prom.
This year, the future business leaders participated in a DECA conference. The conference is an annual event where business and marketing students compete against other high school students throughout the state in case studies and other projects on various business-related fields. In Connecticut, there are approximately 1,100 students each year who participate. NCHS student winners include Ben Durkin for Human Resources Management, Lauren Myers for Personal Financial Literacy, and Charlie Sokolowski for Business Service Marketing. Congrats to all the winners.
On Thursday, March 24th, Charity Link is hosting their annual coffeehouse event. The night will include an acoustic style of entertainment and refreshments will be provided. If you want to sign up, you can contact senior Charlotte Decker or Luke Brand at their school emails or message them on Facebook.
Although you may be used to Principal Egan around school by now, it's hard to believe he's only been here for a little over one semester. Considering all the changes and first impressions he's made, we here at NCTV created a show that the principal himself will be showing on. So make sure to catch Principal's Corner airing later today on Channel 78. Hopefully you can get all your questions answered.
NCTV isn't the only one putting out new content. Over 100 NCHS students and alumni have been busy submitting art for the fourth annual Through Our Eyes art show. The exhibit opens tonight with a public reception from 5 to 7 at Carriage Barn Art Center. The show is only open for a few weeks, so make sure to stop by before March 26th.
You know, Tay, the weather has been so inconsistent lately. I don't know about you, but it seems like spring isn't right around the corner.
Well, Leanne, I wish it was spring, but with the flurries we got this morning, it's not looking too hopeful. Let's go to our newest weather anchor, Maddie Friedland. Maddie.
That's right, Tanisha. There was a chance of snow this morning, so I hope no one had any problems getting to school. Good morning, NCHS. I'm Madeline Friedland for the first time, here to give you this weekend's weather. Although the temperatures should start to warm up by the end of the next week, don't pack away that coat just yet. Today will be cloudy with a high of 37 degrees and dropping down to a low of 25. Moving on to tomorrow, things will begin to warm up just a little bit when the clouds break, with a high of 43 degrees and a low of 28. Keeping to the same temperatures as Saturday, Sunday will have a high of 43 degrees and a low of 28. For those of you driving, watch out for the possibility of snow showers that day as well. Although it doesn't look like it now, the groundhog did predict an early spring with temperatures in the 60s next week. And with that, it will definitely begin to show. I hope everyone enjoys their weekend. Tanasia and Leanne, back to you guys.
Thanks, Madeline, and welcome to the show. Before we go, NCTV would like to wish a very happy birthday to Matthew Hall. If you have any announcements, please email us at nctv78@gmail.com or tweet at us at nctv78. Until next time, this has been Leanne Massioni.
And I'm Tanasia Carfiello. Make sure to check out girls basketball versus St. Joe's and boys hockey versus Norwalk. Have a great weekend, guys.